The Supreme Court has taken suo motu cognizance of the rape and murder of a doctor in R.G. Carr Medical Hospital. Remember, this is the incident that has led to shockwaves across the country. In fact, there are protests happening in different parts of the country. Today, what happened is that a bench led by Chief Justice of India, D.Y. Chandrachud, heard the matter, is supposed to hear the matter on Tuesday, but massive protests are happening at Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata. There is high drama outside the Kolkata Stadium, and these protests are for demanding safety protocols for doctors to be put in place and also justice for the victim of the R.G. Carr Medical Hospital horrific crime and murder. Going across to my colleague Tanushka, who has been covering the protest since morning. Tanushka, tell us what is happening on ground and what is the demand that the protesters have cited?
Right, so this protest that was being held and is still going on by the football fans of the teams of Mohun Bagan and East Bengal. These two teams have been major rivals, and the protest scenes here reach quite a height with police charging on to the protesters here. These two football teams have known to have the fiercest of rivalry, and the Durant Cup, which was all set to happen today, the match got cancelled in the backdrop of this protest. And it's these two teams are known to, you know, not see eye to eye in West Bengal, and they've come together for this cause. They've unified as one for a cause against the brutal rape and murder of this doctor at R.G. Carr Medical Hospital. And the fans here, as you can see around me, there's immense security forces present here, police forces, Kolkata police forces, there's rapid action forces also present here. What we know from the protest site is that police has detained a lot of these fans of these football clubs, and East Bengal and Mohun Bagan are two of India's oldest football clubs, and they out here came together for a cause and to protest for women's safety and for doctors' safety, demanding justice in this case of rape and murder at the R.G. Carr Medical Hospital. The streets, they've been, you know, rallying across this whole stretch in Kolkata, and they've been lathi charged by the police as well out here. High dramatic scenes erupted here. The protesters are still rallying ahead for this cause, demanding justice.
Right, Tanushka, those are the visuals of this protest that's happening in Salt Lake Stadium in Kolkata. This is to demand justice for the victim of the R.G. Carr Medical Hospital. In fact, today is the day when the mother of the deceased has also come out and spoken. She's spoken about the discrepancies in the police investigation. She said that when she found her daughter's body, there was just one piece of cloth on her. So some very unfortunate details are being revealed. Let me go across to my colleague Sunil Prabhu, who covers the Supreme Court for us. Sunil, the role of the judiciary in this matter has been very critical. It's the Calcutta High Court which asked for, the probe to be handed over to CBI, and now the top court has taken cognizance of this matter. Tell us, how do you see this going from here?
So this is a very, very serious and definitely something which the Supreme Court rarely does. Suo motu, the last time they did was in Manipur, where they're now taking suo motu cognizance. It will be top of the board. First matter to be taken up on the Tuesday when the Supreme Court reconvenes. Chief Justice of India, along with his bench, Justice Padiwala and Justice Manoj Mishra, will be looking at this entire issue and hopefully, take cognizance, as you point out. More importantly, to give some semblance of governance to ensure that there is clear clarity, that those who are responsible are brought to book. You cannot carry on like this, as has been happening. And it's in this context, the Chief Justice and the Supreme Court taking suo motu cognizance is definitely a clear sign that they are going to take and address this issue at the earliest.